Okay, so here in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the ImageJ application to analyze the fluorescence from the rotobacter overlays. So first of all, you're going to open up ImageJ. They also have it at 32-bit, but ImageJ works just fine. So we're going to open that up, and then we're going to go into ImageJ, and we're going to open up a file. And I'm going to use the picture Molly Cashin made when we were in Tucson. All right, so here's the picture. Now, first, it doesn't look great because we have a background problem. We didn't have the Aztec blue plastic film over the LEDs then, so we had a little bit of a background problem. You're still going to have a background problem, but this was worse. So what we're going to do is we're going to process the data a little bit. It doesn't actually change the data. It just changes how it looks to us. So we're going to go to Image. We're going to go to Adjust Brightness and Contrast. You see, this is the histogram of the pixels, and they're pretty much the low end. So I'm going to set my minimum closer to the lowest value. I'm going to set my maximum closer to the highest value. And that's a little bit too much. There we go. And we'll set my contrast a little bit higher so I can really see the difference. There. Now, the important thing is not actually changing the data, you notice. It's just changing how we see it, how it's shown on the computer screen to make it a little bit easier for our eyes to pick out what we need to see. There. Okay, so now I've got a fluorescence image here and here and here. All right, so now what I'm going to do is analyze the fluorescence of each of these halos around the algae. These three I can see. This one I can see where the algae were, but I don't really see a halo because this one wasn't making any hydrogen. So this actually tells me this is probably the mutant that doesn't make hydrogen. But that's okay. I've selected the oval one because these are pretty much circles. And I'm going to draw a circle around this one. And then I'm going to go to Analyze, hit Measure. I'm going to move this little thing here so we can actually see it. And then, and this is, actually, you know what, I don't like that. I'm going to change this. All right, and actually I'm going to start again. Don't save that. There, because I changed this. All right, hit Measure again. Our first value will go in here. Now, this is really important. Don't draw a new circle. Just move this circle here because it'll have the exact same area. Hit Analyze, Measure again. That'll be number two. Move it over here. Centering on the algae. That'll be number three. And then I'll center this on the algae as well. That spot there at which I assume the algae are. And we're going to measure again. Now I'm going to go to the results, and there we go. So area one was this one, two this one, three that one, four that one. You're going to have to look at the plate and figure out which strains these correspond to, but you can do that. Now what it has here is the area, which is about 24,194 pixels in each one. The nice thing is by picking the same area, I make each measurement I can compare each one. This is the mean value. Basically, it added up all of the brightness of each pixel in this 24,194 pixels, and then divided by 24,194 to give me the average brightness of all the pixels in this area, and then that area, and then that area. And that's what 1, 2, 3, and 4 are. The minimum and maximum are the lowest intensity pixels and highest intensity pixels in those areas, which is not actually that important for us to know. Really, this is the mean, the average that we care about. So what I'm going to do is take these, I'm going to just copy them, and then I'm going to start up a spreadsheet. in Excel, which is way too big. Move it down here. Okay, so this would be strain. You're going to have to go in and figure out which those are. This is the area. This is the, call this AOI, area of interest. This is the absolute area in pixels. This is the mean. This is the minimum value and maximum value. I'm just going to line them center just to make it a little bit easier to read. Make those bold. Okay, now, here is what you're going to do. Oh yeah, and we're not quite done. I just realized, let me move this over here. We really need to get a background value, like where there is no algae. What does that look like? So let's do that. Let's move this over here, kind of in between. Could use that, you could use this. I guess it doesn't matter. I guess I'll use this. I'll try both. Okay, maybe a little bit here. Okay, look at the results. Here we are. Well, we probably didn't need to do that. Let me just copy these over and you can see why I'm saying that. Okay, these are empty. The reason why is because actually our control of, and I'm assuming this is the no H2 making strain. You notice its mean value is 22.777, which is actually lower than these guys. So this is basically the value if you have no hydrogen, okay? Because look, it's not any different than the background values somewhere in the plate where there are no algae at all. Okay, so what we can do is subtract that. Okay, so let's say this is strain A and B and C. Okay, well, let's say this will be signal minus background. And we'll just say that this value is the background. Okay. So I'll just say this, I'm going to call this my signal, and I'm going to subtract the background, which is this guy. And I'm going to put a little dollar sign in front of the 5. You'll see why in a minute, because when I take this and then copy it here, you see this is this number minus that. This number went down along with this calculation, but this number stayed the same because the dollar sign fixes it. Okay. So what this is saying is that the strain that doesn't make hydrogen, has no signal, okay? This is all background. Same thing here. But these are real values. These are a measure of how much hydrogen strains A, B, and C were making. These numbers right here. So I'm gonna highlight those. Okay, and this is the number that you want, okay? It's the signal, the fluorescent signal, that is due to making hydrogen. And you can then compare these strains and figure out who made more hydrogen in this assay. And then if you had two plates where you have them side by side and grown under different conditions, you might be able to compare those as well, as long as you took the fluorescence pictures in the exact same way. Okay, and that's basically how you do the analysis. And there are other fancier tricks that you can play with ImageJ, but what I've shown you is the basic way you can do it. All right, and that concludes this video.